Hello, this is Patty, the Shabby Pink Stamper, and I just want to... I have no idea what this final project is going to look like. I do in my mind, but you know how that can go. I want to make a necklace, and so I've been pulling some different items from Deb's store, Gone Artsy, the shop, and just... some things that I had. This is just some cheesecloth that I had dyed, and I usually use it in my cards and stuff, so I had that laying around. So this is a 90 inches of seam binding that I've colored up and tried to make look vintage with a couple colors. I had that done. And then this is a 12 inch piece. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm making a necklace, and the connector, I'm sorry, I've made this video a few times, so I'm going to put the connector here and the connector here for the back behind the neck. So I need the doubled, I need it to be doubled. I'm going to have that tied there and this tied here. So I hope you can see me. Nope. I'm going in about 15 inches from the end that has the two ends, and I'm just going to tie this here. Yeah, right. I gotta figure out what doing. This is the 12 inch piece. I'm going to tie it to this piece at the 15 inch mark. Hopefully, we'll see what it ties in at. And the reason I'm doing that is because it's going to be covered. So let's see. Yep, about 15 inches in. So let me just tighten this up so it doesn't move. Okay, so I've got the 12 inch piece here. I've got the 15 inches here. And then I'm going to tie this let's see how far down I am here. At about 12 inches, so we'll see how that looks. I'm going to use fabric tack, or I may sew it. At least stitch it with a couple stitches, okay? So what I end up with is, when you lay it down, this is going to be my connector. This is going to be my necklace. Okay, so this side's a little longer than that because I'm going to cut into the video where I fabric glued that down, and I'm going to add that. I'm going to use my fabric fix. And I'm going to leave that in there because I kind of like that. Like I said, it's 90 inches of seam binding. There was a 12 inch. This is the 12 inch piece tied here to this piece. And if it's confusing, I'm so sorry, but I can explain if you have any questions. Now, this is the flower, like I said before, that I made and I used on the hat, the derby hat that I made last month. the end of the month. And then I just kind of tacked it down a little bit to make it smaller. And then added some of the seam binding that I've colored up. Okay. And then this was the lace that I used on the bottles that I had covered the whole bottle with. And it comes white. Coffee and some dyes, washed it by hand and dried it, washed it, sprayed it to make sure it's not going to come off. Onto anything. And so where I've tied this piece, now remember this is the longer piece, so where I've tied that, I'm going to add this. I'm going to use the fabric tack. And I'm going to leave a tail because I want it to show. When I tied things, I left tails because if I want to cut it off at one point, I will. So what I'm going to do with this one is I'm going to see how I can get confused what is what. So I'm holding it here. And on the shorter, I'm just going to twist it around 3 times. And then I'm going to loosen it up because that's too tight. I don't like that. And I did put some vanilla, some essential oil that I had to get rid of the coffee smell. I like the smell of coffee, but not on my jewelry. Okay. Very good. So then I'm going to cut this off or I may leave it hanging a bit. Let's just make sure it's the right length that I want. And then I have this cheesecloth that I had dyed. I've had it in my stash. I've dyed it and all of that good stuff. And I'm going to use fabric tack here. Like I said, it's all going to be covered. All of this right here, this where it's bunched up, that's going to be covered. So I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to wrap it a couple times, I think just twice. Okay, and then, or maybe 3 times, because I will attach this underneath. Attach this first to the knot in the back. Now I'm going to add the seed bead trim and let's see, okay, if I have to, like I said, tack it down with some stitches, I will do that. because I do not want this to come apart. And then I'm going to wrap this around. And I'm going opposite of the way that I had gone before with the stuff. I can't remember the name. All of a sudden my mind is blank. I want to say cottage cheese. I know it's, what is it? Oh my goodness, whatever. Okay. Perfect. Just what I wanted. Okay, so maybe I will just see, do I want to wrap it one more time? Yes, I better. Since I'm wrapping this differently than I did before, I'm actually going all the way around, but okay, so let me see. I want to make sure that stays. I like it. So again, I'm going to cut it right here at this spot. And yes, I will lose some beads, but it's okay. All this is going to be covered. And I save these when they fall off. I save them because I will use them. Hope I'm in film. Yes. This is the last bit I have left. I had just ordered that and had to use it on my bottles and everything. Okay, but at least I'm using it all. So I may tack this down just right there because that's the only place I don't like the way it's hanging, but we'll see. Okay, and then this is the trim that I got from Deb's shop, and it has pearls and bling. And I think I'm going with that up there. Let me hold off on that for a bit till I know for sure. Because it's either, am I going to go with gold, or am I going to go with silver, or am I going to go with both? Silver and gold. I think I'm going to tack this down to the cheesecloth. See, I had cottage cheese on my mind. It was cheesecloth. So I'm going to tack it. These are from Deb's shop. Oh, I just realized there's something else I have to grab. And it's a two-piece. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one of these in there. I've got to decide which words I want to use. And so I was kind of thinking this laugh and sweet I could put in there. Or happy and dance. I have two of those. Divine and princess. Beauty, secret, believe, always. So I don't think I'll do the believe. And why I need them to, why it's important that I like both, like I was thinking maybe this princess, and I don't know if it's too big, is because I'm going to wrap it in here, and then I'm going to hang that from either this side or this side, and I'm going to put some things in there. So Let's see, how does this feel? It works. So if it should spin, it would say divine or princess. Sweet and laugh, I do like that. So sweet. And I'm going to put some beads in there. I might go with that. Sweet and laugh, or beauty and secret, dance and happy. No, I'm going to go with that one. I have all these beautiful pieces like this one. That would look nice. It's what I'm thinking. Can you see all the way over there? Maybe I need to lift my light. So over here on this side, like I said, maybe I'll put this, hang this from here. Put this on there. If I don't use that, maybe I'll use this one. Which I kind of like that one. Or I could use this. And then I can all add some seam binding behind that too. So let me decide what I want to do. So hold on, I'm going to run and go find the my jewelry wire. Hold on. A piece. I was thinking I might be able to put a couple beads. These pink ones. Three of those. Two of the beige. Oops. And these are all glass beads. Let's see if I've added too much now. I don't think so. Well, let's just see how this works out. I don't know. I'm just going to guess. Guesstimate. This is about 15 inches. I may not need that much, but just in case. Wonder if I want to... Nope, I do. Okay, so what I'm going to do is go ahead and put this in. I don't know if you can see, but I went through the side one, not the bottom one, but through a side one. Loop, side loop. And I have a shorter length and a longer length, so I'm going to take the longer length. And I had intended to use this for a Christmas type scene, but I couldn't find the deer. I found a deer. I was going to put the deer in there, but I don't think it fit. I was going to do a pair of earrings. Let me just show you. This would have been so cute, but it wouldn't fit. Wouldn't that have been adorable? I was going to do a Christmas scene with a Christmas tree and everything. But it didn't work out. Okay, I'm trying to figure out how I'm going to attach all this together. So I'm looping that around, and I have to have a loop to be able to tie the, to attach it to the ribbon or whatever I'm going to attach it with. I'm going to have to go around again because there's no guarantee that will not slip off. So let me come to the middle. I'm glad I chose five and to skip five because I'll go into that center one. Oops. I'll crimp it around this, twist it. I just want to get rid of any sharp edges. This is laugh or sweet. And I have this little loop here. So I can hang that. I think I will attach it to this side since I'm going to have my flower on this side. What do you think? Or do I want to hang this from the flower? And over here I was just thinking something a little more subtle. I have this I had made prior, and I may have to remake it or fix this up, but it's a leaf. I could attach that. See, it's just an S pin, and so you would just take this and you would. It really is easy. It's just my fingernails are getting in the way. They are too long. You just slide it, and that's what it would look like in the back. I have this green over here. This beautiful pearl and rhinestone. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. My concern is having it smooth against your skin, you know, whoever wears it, their skin. All right, so we're going to attach these. Attach it to the cloth, the seam binding, and then attach this over that. Cut it. I like that. So it's just a touch of gold. Not too much, so because I wrapped it, I like it. It's not too much gold showing. Okay, so let me attach this. Put that down. I love it. I love it. Love it, love it. Okay, so it's just subtle enough. Looking for a jump ring, I decided I'm going to make my own bead here. I mean, an attach a bead. This has whatever you call it, a loop there, so I can attach the bird cage. And so I have this clear pink glass bead. Just, I may change it, just trying to decide what I want to do here. Let's see, I might use this pink one instead. Nope, I like the clear. Okay, so I'm using the clear, then the bead from Deb's shop. I don't know if she still has those beads, but they're so beautiful, and in person, the camera's not picking up how pretty it is. Okay, so I think I'll do that. That looks good. Maybe I'll put one more white one at the end. Bend it. I'm not an expert on making jewelry. I'm gonna have to cut this. So there we go. And then it is a jump ring. And I have to put this, attach this to the so you open it up and attach it to the bird cage, attach it to the bottom. A little bigger, that loop is a little bigger than I like, that jump ring, but it's okay. I'm going to put a few other things in there, and then you bend it back. I think I'm going to do two and then one. I had found this that I made too. Let's see, do I like that? Yep. Okay, so that's what I'll attach. I usually keep paper towels nearby, and I don't have any, so... Okay, so I tack that down. And stitch it in a few places. Okay, so let me clean up some of this mess here. Ah, there we go, just the right amount. Okay, I'm going to let that sit, and then I'm going to attach the beautiful bird cage to it. While that's drying, I'm going to go over to this. And I am going to use this doily. And you can find this in Deb's shop. I wanted a little bit of white in here, so I've got it with that. But this is a off-white, but it's got white in it too. Okay, what I've decided, I filled this with some Fabri-Tac, and then I'm just looping some of this in there. Making a big mess. Okay, and then putting some green, packing that all down. I think that's how I can get this to stay. How come I just cannot stay on camera? I'm so sorry. I added some of the muslin back there on both sides, and then some of this lace back there too for that. I added the bird, and I added this pearls. Hope you like my project. Get over to Deb's shop. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, just let me know. Thanks. Bye.